Hi guys, if you're just joining me, this is the second game of the evening. It's Trent versus Uni of East Anglia. Good win for Trent in the first game. Always nice to beat your rivals, so it's good to beat Uni of, and we should see them carry that form into the game against UEA. Please bear with me again. This is my second stream, so I should be getting slightly better by now, but I'll keep working on it. I know I said in the first game that this wasn't a game I knew too much about, but I do enjoy this map just because of the nice long sight lines for sniping. But yeah, Trent's first game I think went really well. They took six rounds in the bounce and got off to a good start, and it just sort of got them going really quickly for the game, and they never really looked back. And hopefully they can keep that sort of pace going into this game. We should see the teams ready up. I think it's going to be a knives only first to decide who goes what side. And again, I won the knife only round last time, so just waiting on a couple of reconnections, I think, just because UEA have had to swap a member out because we spent ages waiting for one person and then they can't even play. So shouldn't be too much longer. Again, if you do have any feedback at all, anything to say about my streaming, like I say, I will take it into account because it is only my second stream and hopefully I should get a bit better. Most organised team EU. I'm not going to win any prizes for organisation, certainly. There we go. So I finally got a 5-on-5. Love a bit of Go Trent in the chat as well. I do try and be unbiased, but obviously going to Trent, it does make it a little bit more difficult for me, so, because I do want Trent to win. Try not to be too excited about them, giving Uni of a thumping, but 16-7's pretty solid. Yeah, we will get into a knife only battle shortly. We're getting some complaints of lag, but I hope they're not serious. The game was scheduled to start at 15:15, but like we said, they're not going to win any prizes for organisation. We will get there eventually, though. Here we go then, so knives only round first. Well, straight up mid, knives only. We'll get to stabbing and see who goes what side. Nothing like a good knife fight. I'm not even sure if they're actually going yet. I think we were waiting for a pause and they've just gone for it. No bribing. Non-stop problems, it seems, so far. Not one player not approved. Oh, right, okay, they've got a player who hasn't approved. Only one, though, so we're going back into a cheeky warm-up, and I'll be back up in a second when we're ready to go. Right, looks like we are going to get the go. So we're going to go for the knife only round. And this will decide what side. So one apiece so far. Two on two, and Trent take the knife only round and can decide, pick their own side. So four kills there for Yak in the knife round, and Yak's gone straight for picking the terrorist side. We'll see armor bought up on two from Trent, three from, oh, all from Trent, and most of UEA. Trent pushed straight towards B. All five, and five going to run into three here. Smokes go out. I see some quick pistol spray and some tags, and one down from UEA. They brought down two. Only Rage Bear down on the Trent side. It's a 3-on-2, 2-on-2 situation. The plant goes out. Birdo brings down one. Well, pretty sure he knows where the other one is. And Isaac just on the cover. See him bring down Isaac, and he's taken out McBurdo as well, and he's going to go in for the defuse. Just about got enough time here, I think. Yeah. So UEA take the first round, and it's good to convert. Being 2-1 down and still managing to pull a round out of there. So pulled that one out of their arse. Everyone's going to buy up on the submachine guns apart from one on Trent. And we've got a FAMAS on the UEA side. Again, rush for B, and it's going to be defended. Grenades going out in the channels. They've dropped down, and a quick exchange there. And Trent come around the corner and get gunned down and take it to 2-on-1. So two pretty bad rounds for them. Rage Bear yet to get off the mark. So you here take an early 2-0 lead, but we'll see how Trent can respond. They're going to go the other way this time and see fire spread for A. Good smoke out there just to cover the movement. I'm going to see him push forward a little and get sprayed at, but gets the kill and just gets a tag for it. Does well to turn it into a 2-on-2 situation. You got one at B, one at A, and both on the A side carrying the bomb. And they're going to press on for this. Will he defend it? He's got a good shot off there and brings him down. So it's 2-on-1. And they've both got the drop on him here at A. And he gets bursted down. So again, Trent go around towards A. And reveals the AWP. And I'm moving just towards B, see if they can find out a little more information just to as to where they are mainly. There's again, a bit tentative on it. You may only get the drop on him if he walks around that corner. Smokes up. Oh, gets a couple of sprays off, but gets bursted down. It becomes a 4-on-2. So, 3-on-1, and we'll see if he can pull anything out here. They're going to try and bring him down with the grenades. He's got two tagged, so you know, a couple of good hits. Oh, he's going to walk straight into the AWP. Oh, unlucky. Didn't even have to move his sights. So they're going to rush B this time. It's the first time the pace has really slowed down for the train. It's been a straight rush, and they've smoked up that main corridor. And it looks like if they go on much further, they're going to get looped round on. Brings them down. That's a triple kill. And just get cut down. That's a 5-0 wipe, and things not going well for Trent for the first five rounds. Let's get a little look at the average damage, and you see it's low. They're really getting walked over at the minute. So they're going to spread out a little. That's a quick 1-for-1 trade there. Rage Bear's picked up an AWP for himself. I've got him spraying down that corridor. Getting a few tags for the spray. Quick two kills there with the AWP. He's going to chuck the incendiary out, forces him out, and then sprays him down. So be well covered. They've got the one out scouting here from Trent. They're going to throw the grenades in and see what they can get out of it. So it looks like they're going to commit to this. Three into B in the 3-on-2. They know where they are, so oh, he's brought him down nicely there. And it goes from a 3-on-2 to 2-on-1. Looks like he's just gonna sit and defend the AWP there. I can't see him getting out for a plant here. And he's just going to back up to save the money. It's a 3-2 split. Trent going to go push more on the A side. Get a quick kill there. There comes 4-on-4, evened up. Lovely reflex shot to get the kill there. Trent have not had a good time of it in these first couple of rounds. They just seem to be getting caught out in all the skirmishes, never quite getting a good drop on anyone. But again, it'll be another case of just, well, trying to defend what you've got, but losing out. That gives two guns over to two AWPs over to the to UEA, and it's really not gone well these first couple of rounds for Trent. We'll see what they can do to pull it back, but it's going to take a big effort. Again, committing towards A and getting an exchange out of it. Grenade goes down. He's got the plant off, but he's got to defend it. And I don't think he's got it in him to win the 2-on-1 here. He doesn't. And they're going to get the defuse off. Again, they push towards A. And they're not quite going with the. They're lacking a bit of commitment. Oh, and he gets taken out nicely. Two quick pickoffs there, and now they can push on. Again, this looks promising, but it's a. Split defence, so as soon as they know, they're now going to move in to defend, but get brought down, and it's going to be a one-man army thing if he manages to win this one from here. So yeah, I think he'll just defend the keep hold of the AWP and give this one up. So finally get around on the board, and hopefully that can give him a bit of momentum and push back into this. So they're out on the hunt, and they may well run into him here, but he's well tucked away. A great headshot. Reveals himself and the grenade goes in. They're a bit penned in here. If they can get out, they can make good advantage of that. Well, make good advantage just like that and get the kill. I'm going to push on with the smoke. Lets them out a little bit. He's going to come into... Oh, just badly timed. And again, Trent just building up a little bit of momentum and just pushing their way back in. And again, almost a full wipe for nothing, but just one death. So again, just building a little bit of momentum, just pushing their way back in. It's amazing how quickly you can see the economy switch over, can't you? Yeah, just... Thought he had the cover of smoke and gets brought down. Oh, he's got the drop on him brilliantly there. Quick burst and yeah, he gets two kills for his troubles. So Trent turned it into a 3-on-2. Two on the ramp, one just pushing towards B. Again, pace is slow right down, a bit tentative, a bit touchy, and they're so close to each other without even really knowing it. And one of them's gonna go down. It's just a case of who makes the mistake. Back away, and we'll see him move towards A, go for the plant. And again, quickly goes from 3-on-2 to 2-on-1, and nice headshot with the pistol to take the win. And just when Trent had built up a little bit of momentum, they've been stopped there, and hopefully it doesn't stop them completely because they're looking quite a bit behind here. Pace this has slowed right down, and hopefully that'll suit Trent. So need to find a way back in. So smoke goes out, and they're gonna just hold back, look for some information. First kill going the way of Trent, just bursting down Chaz the Mister. The grey's going out, and they're going to move on A. And again, still 5-on-3, 5-on-2. They've got a great position for the setup here. They do get a return kill, but the plant's there, and they've got 4 on defence. They should take this. Going on the hunt and seeing if they can get him, and he's gonna get dropped. Just unlucky to walk around the corner straight into a hail of bullets. Now if Trent can take this in, 10-5, gives him at least a chance. But we'll have to see a bit of deagling. It's going to move in. Windsor spray war. A quick 2 there for Rage Bear. And try to make it 5-on-2. return kill. I've still got pressure on this approach to A. Just going to keep them pinned in and pinned back and see where to go. And they're going to make the move towards B. And UEA have noticed, I think, because they're moving to defend as well. So we'll see a 3-on-2. And he's going to burst him and takes him down. A 3-on-1, well smoked, because they know exactly where he is. And I've just got to wait for him to make the move. And a great shot to take him down. And a quick pause. Time to just relax. UEA don't want to let it slide here, because you don't want to give up the momentum straight into the changeover, because it's a good way to lose a couple of rounds while you or you just adjust. So I have a quick team speak issue. I think the rounds that Trent have won, that they've just been the rounds that have just, you know, the pace has slowed down and they've just sort of calmed down, taken control of the situation, and, you know, really thought about where they're going to commit to before charging straight forward. The first couple of rounds, they really really rushed into positions where they didn't quite have the upper hand, and say paid for it with several rounds on the bouncer going down. And just when the pace has slowed down and calmed down a little, they've come out of it better. So if they can just slow the pace down into the changeover and keep calm and keep control, then we should see them at least come back into the match, if not winning it. But going in 10-5 or even, you know, 9-6 would be definitely give them a chance. Always love to see it raining guns. Chance to take a look at the stats as well. So again, as you'd sort of think, you're gonna see UEA up on average damage, but I've seen some good plays certainly out of Etepe. I'm guessing that's some sort of Pepe reference. Nothing but the finest Pepes. See, it all tends to be a case of, as you can see from time alive, it tends to be a case of they're just getting bursted down and really short. They almost, it just collapses for them. It's going well and then just collapses. So it's either they're rushing in too quickly or they're not quite holding composure, shall we say. So, yeah, just a nice, calm, slow approach, and they should be all right. Just going to back up to save the money. looks like we might actually get going again. Apart from the crash out, looks like everything's fixed, so I think we're going to be alright. A little bit of rubbish banter on the chat between the teams. The DOS threats and Geordie Shaw references, which is not at all cool. Here we go. I'm actually going to get back into it then. Back to that rushing. Don't want to see them moving too quickly here. Just make sure they take their time, think it out a little before they just charge in. Plenty of shots going off, some tags well got for Trent, but they are going to lose Rage Bear to a quick burst. Black's made his way around the back here. And gets two kills for his troubles. And it becomes a 3-on-1. And is he even playing? Looks like they've gone without him. Well, this might be the easiest round of their lives. I can literally stand on the bomb. Has he moved the whole time? I don't think he has. Well. Bit of a mistake. Let's see if he moves this round. Not buying up, so I'm guessing he's must have left. So it makes it 4-on-5. Moved away, get a quick kill there. B-Wall defenders. Quick burst fight there, and you get two for the price of one. Even up for a very short period of time before it becomes 3-on-2. So smoke's going out, and they're going to make the move for it. I've got the bomb defended here. Just spray Yak down through the smoke and kill him off. So they're going to go into the change. Well, 10 for 5, which is good. Probably not good enough, but depends how well they play on the defense, really. One thing you can say, he's definitely making sure he's keeping his equipment. Counter-terrorists win. So the change round goes in 11-4. I think UEA might take this here. Still haven't seen any movement out of him, so I'm guessing that is it. He's given up on life. So ISEC gets tagged. Quick spray war ends in a headshot. But tagged down to 22 for it. So it becomes a, well, 4-on-4. We're running from the distance and two very quick kills. And it's a 2-on-1. 1-on-2. So he's seen his movement, he can just protect the bomb here, but trying to smoke, he's going to move in under the cover of it. Just can he get the drop on him? Sprays. Well played. Just reflexes are slightly too quick for him. Well done to win a round from behind when you're playing with only four people. So. Luckily, they stayed in it that long, really. Quick spray from the sub down the A channel. The run straight into race there, here. And a spray war gets in the kill. Four for four. And a mistimed grenade sees him go down. So I've got the bomb in the channels near A. Gotta make the move for it. Get sprayed down, it becomes 2-on-1. Even though he'd thrown that flashbang. Coming back into it, it's going to take a big effort to win 10 on the bounce here, so we'll see what they can do. I can't see them winning it from here, but you never know. got around nicely there to get the kill. Runs into a whole team, and he can only take one with him. He gives his position away. And he's got him distracted while the team makes the move for B. He's stuck at A and they're going to go in for the plant. Unless he realises pretty quick. Yeah, this looks like it. What can he do from here? Will he go for it or will he save his equipment? Yeah, he's going to go for the save, I think. It'll be a tough one to get around. A bit of love for the chicken. I have found him. He does get a kill, but at 2 health, I can't see him. Yeah, goes down. They do have 5 players again now, so at least it's back to 5-on-5. So they'll go for the 4 protect B. He does get found here, and he's going to have to take on the whole team on his own if he's not careful. Yeah, and gets taken down on his own. 4-on-1, he didn't really have a chance. Round 2. One tagged on each side. I just thought about it there a bit too much before shooting him, but does get the double kill off for it. Didn't snatch at the chance. And they're well set up to defend B and the bomb here, so he's already tagged down. Gonna spray and get nothing for it. Except give away his position. And with the 2 of them defending the bomb, they should take this. It's going to move round. Take that asset. It does get the double kill. Almost 2 down already. You got 2 fainting towards B. And the commitment's going to come in at into A here. All moving around and only 1 defending. And again, he's having to take out a whole team on his own, and he's going to get taken down. Still 3-on-3. 3-on-1. Brutally taken down with that easy headshot. And, Trent may be paying the price for having him bursting out for a good 10 minutes. Red goes in into the channel near A. This time 3 towards B, 2 towards A. A couple of burst exchanges leaves one down for Trent. That becomes two. Two apiece defending. Wins the burst floor there and the exchange kills. One on three. Okay. I'm going to go for the plant here. Plenty of space, but he's going to get come up from behind and he's going to get taken out. Hit with a grenade. Down. So with all the momentum on UEA, it looks like it's going to be their game here. Quick 2-on-1 there to take someone down. Smoke goes up, but there's not anyone there. Reflex shot with the AWP there. One more kill. Takes the win. Yeah. Unlucky there for Trent. They've one win, one loss for the evening, but could have gone a whole lot worse. And good to get a win over UniOv. So thanks for watching my stream. If you stayed with me even through the gap. And I'll post again when I've got another stream going up. Thanks, guys.